is the referee tonight. Bob Hodges and Kevin Collins on the lines. There's Koharski. Maybe a surprise starter, but really, Greg Millen played well in Game 5. And there he is. He's in again tonight for St. Louis. Now, when it comes to playoffs, you've got to have a playoff goaltender. And the Leafs have one here in Ken Reagan. He's been a superstar in this series.
He can certainly take credit for the big win in St. Louis Tuesday. And Doug Gilmour, who's been shut down for two games, is going to be looking into the eyes of Dan Daou all night. John Brophy told me this morning that they had to win tonight. It was too much to expect. Three wins in St. Louis.
Gilmour, Federko, and Hunter starting up front for St. Louis. Benning and Ramage are the defensemen, and Salming is out there with Lands, and the Leafs shoot it in. Daou, Allison, and Domfus for Toronto. And right off the bat, Koharski goes to work.
Mark Hunter gets a foolish penalty right away, and you know, Jacques Martin has been saying it for two games now, we can't take unnecessary penalties.
First penalty of the hockey game, and it comes after only 10 seconds of play. Mark Hunter for roughing.
Watch Hunter, he's the right winger, number 20. And very shortly into the game here, Damfus is holding his stick. That's why Hunter's mad. Now he kicks his stick out of the way, and here's the penalty right there.
So Jacques Martin already feels he's in a little bit of a hole because the first goal has been so important in this series. Inechek, you see there, coming out. So he'll have five and Clark with him. And Lands and Salming remain on. Lehman is finished for the season with a cracked kneecap. That's Clark on the boards. Misses it. And the Blues. Pretty good penalty killers out there for St. Louis. Shoot it down the ice. Reeds and Mahar are the two forwards, and they're very quick. Ramage and Benning, the defenseman, Salming. The only man there with Reeds forechecking, but he stick-handled out and made the move at the blue line offside. And that has been, I suppose, Harry, a bit of a fault in the Maple Leafs' power play. They've been carrying that puck. That is one man.
Trying to beat two or sometimes even three. You have the extra man. You have to use him. Millen scares the Leafs on the shoot-ins because he's so quick, and he gets out and gets the puck. And St. Louis has done a great job at almost eliminating the Toronto power play.
Iafredi is on now, and Vibe will move up. Vibe can't shoot it, rolls it off to the right. Clark back to Kotsopoulos, and Mahar cleared it to the line. Kotsopoulos didn't know it, but it hit him, and it was still onside had he played it. Iafredi back, 1:20 seconds left on the lead power play. They haven't had a shot yet. Up to center ice. This is Kotsopoulos, they're onside again. It hit Benning's stick. And this crowd very worked up, and they want to see at least a shot. Millen hasn't had one to handle yet, for that matter, nor has Reagan, but the Leafs are on a power play.
Well, here are two guys that were as nervous as any two players. Both of them know the importance of this game. St. Louis is history if they lose, and Brophy has to take the long trip back to St. Louis. But St. Louis has been a team that's dodged the bullet this year and done things the hard way. They had to win four in a row to finish first.
Salming again. He hit Wickenheiser with that clearing pass. Lands his back, and Wickenheiser is in forechecking. Now it's whipped in off the boards back to the net, and Osborne is starting away. Wickenheiser tried to stop him. Here is Thomas getting some room over there. Thomas coming across the line, speeding in. The puck comes loose, and it's cleared back down the ice by Bothwell. 40 seconds left of the penalty to St. Louis. Leafs haven't had a shot yet. Thomas tried to do it himself. Salming picks up the loose puck. He's going up and had it poked away. The Leafs are unable to get anything going. This could be a big break for the St. Louis Blues. If they can kill this penalty in this fashion, they'll undoubtedly get a big lift. Fired down the ice again, this time a little high over the glass into the crowd. 18 seconds remaining in the St. Louis penalty.
Mark Osborne's been a silently been a real big leaf player. You know, the defensive type players, the non-big goal scorers, have starred for the Leafs. And I thought this young man who they got from the Rangers late in the year played an excellent game in St. Louis, despite the fact he got a goal. I mean all the rest of the good things a guy like Osborne does for you.
And the other guy they got from the New York Rangers, Mike Allison, was a standout in St. Louis.
That he was.
The Blues, their backs to the wall here. The Leafs leading the series 3-2, and Durant Clark couldn't find the pass. Off the boards, it comes to the line. Here's a chance for Dow. He didn't shoot it. Here's a shot. A quick one by Clark, stopped by Millen. First shot on goal for the Maple Leafs. A low shot by Clark. Now five. His shot deflected off the net. Clark is in there with five. The St. Louis penalty over, and Hunter is up on the play. It's Mahar carrying the puck in. Hunter takes his high shot over the net. Now the Blues at full strength do a little hitting now. Nearing the 3-minute mark. Five didn't see it. Break it out of the net. Dumped it to the corner. Hatsopoulos ran his man Lemieux into the boards. Clark threw a check into Bell. The Blues are in. Lemieux shot. Reagan stopped it. He's without the helmet. Hunter fired it back to the net. Bedard goal. Tried to slip it around Reagan as he did in St. Louis. He lost it. Here's a lead pass. Brad Smith going in. Scores. This place is go crazy. He's a crowd favorite. Look at him standing up for Brad Smith.
Even Ballard thinks it's quite a move. Of all the guys to score the first goal, Brad Smith is the one John Brophy would choose. It ignites his team and the crowd, and what a move he makes. Millen gambles on the poke check and loses. And Smith, who got a nice pass here to get in the clear, makes the Leafs look good with a good move, and nobody turns this crowd on like Smith.
2:55, the time of the goal. Clark assisted. Where did he get that speed?
He could hear that guy from behind him, and he wasn't going to let him catch. He doesn't get in on the goalie alone very often.
The Leafs lead 1-0. Here's Allison up there. He tipped it back out over the line. The Leafs are offside with Lands coming in. Dow was trapped.
Wendell Clark makes a lovely pass to put Smith in the clear. And Smith makes a lovely play on Millen, who I think realized who it was and figured, well, Smith doesn't get in alone on goalies very often. Maybe I can catch him by surprise. But he didn't, and it's 1-0 Toronto.
Benning coming back for St. Louis. His team now down by a goal and a game in the series. Benning dumped it off to the corner. Meyer Brady back there with Salmi. Tried to take it away from Cavallini and did. The two players hit the ice. Bourgeois moving up. Cavallini left it for Pasloski. And Meyer Brady pinned him. Now Dao out. Down the right side. Dao coming across the line. Trying to go around. Benning hit the side of the net. It bounced around the goal. And the Blues, Cavallini got it out to Pasloski, up with Gilmore. Gilmore. So slippery going in there, but this time rolled a racket, he cleared it. Now dumped it to the middle. Now Boos whacked at it, and Millen will have to clear it. Pasloski dropped it back. 1-0 Toronto, and the Blues move it up. Bothwell hit by Inichak, bouncing puck in front of Reagan. Stopped by Natras, he was hit immediately by Inichak. Kill, bumped around by Reeves, but got the pass away to Dom Foose, and then he was hit by Reeves. Now out to center. That's Rick Vibe trying to find room. Couldn't get a shot away. A weak one went in there. Millen stopped it. Inichak might be getting a penalty. Inichak was up end. It's St. Louis getting a penalty. Inichak has the puck. Reagan on the bench. They have the extra man on now. And here's a chance for Lance. Shoot! Drilled it wide. The Leafs, the extra man, they still have it. Now it's grabbed by St. Louis. And here's a cross-checking penalty against the St. Louis Blues. Gilmore is going off.
Rick Fife gets a shot on goal here. It's a weak one. And over to the right of your screen here, as Inichuk comes into the play, Gilmore right there cross-checks him right into the board.
Gilmore in the penalty box. And again, the Maple Leafs with a man advantage. 1-0 Toronto. And the Blues kill the first penalty, and they shoot it down the ice to start this one. 30 seconds eaten up with the penalty. Now Toronto moving it. That's Osborne. Dropped it back. Cortnell shoots it from outside the line. It went in. Thomas going in after it. It comes back to Salming. On the boards to the line. Thomas reaching in. Here's Salming again. Saw path right in front of the slot. Back to Lang. Shoots off the leg. Blues trying to clear it. They do. Knocked down the ice by Ramage.
One thing that hurts St. Louis in a penalty-filled game is that Ramage and Benning kill the first half of all the penalties, play all the power plays, and it's a long night if there's a lot of each of those.
1-0 Toronto. Here's Osborne coming in after it. Osborne had it taken away, and Benning lifts a high one. Over Katsopoulos down the ice. 55 seconds left for the St. Louis penalty. Their second of the game. And the Leafs start down. Vine shoots it as he hits center. Clark in after it. Comes back to the Blues. They can't get it out. Now they will. All the way down to the right of Regan. Katsopoulos back. Net was the defenseman who cleared that one. Leafs start up again. Right to Natras comes Iafredi. Iafredi put it off his stick and in wide of the net. Domboos is bumped. It comes to Iafredi. He takes a shot. That's off Natras. And the Blues are going to kill this penalty. They shoot it to center. 15 seconds left in the penalty. And the Leafs come in again. Clark had it knocked away. And it's down the ice. Gilmore gets ready to come back on as Domboos circles. He can carry it. Domboos, a good stick handler, got in there, had it lifted off his stick. Gilmore is now out of the penalty box, and the puck was grabbed by him right away. He gave it to Bourgeois. Bourgeois centered it. Domboos turning, moved away from Hunter, and again from Hunter. And then he rolled it up to Clark. Bourgeois took it away from him. Look out! Clark ran into Bourgeois. He hit him hard. That's about a dozen checks he's gotten from Clark in this series. Center ice, Natras flipped it in. 1-0 is the score. Toronto on Brad Smith's breakaway goal, and he's on the ice again now. Natras batted ahead. Yaremchuk, he's in the lineup wearing number 16 with Lehman out with the injury. Clark starts away to Yaremchuk. He can fly. He's going in hard. Yaremchuk with Smith, and he couldn't get the pass over. There's Smith. Knocked it back of the net. Here's Smith again. He was hit, but he got the pass away and went into the crease. Listen to this crowd. They're really buzzing now with Smith going hard at it. The Blues can't get across the line. Lemieux was upended up the blue line as they near the 9-minute mark of the opening period. And Therrien just dumped it to center. Smith up forechecking. Went by Smith. That pass hit and down the ice. And the Leafs in control, leading by a goal. Start up. Therrien had to turn around and couldn't get Root's pass. Now the Blues are in. Cavallini shoots. Stopped by Regan. That's his toughest so far. Cavallini's knocked down, and the Leafs get out again. Therrien comes out with Allison. Therrien, a little bit tired on this ship now, wants to get off, but he has to roll it over. He does. Allison in. An offside is called at the St. Louis blue line. They scored a goal the other night in St. Louis early in the game. Into the third minute, that goal by Federko, and it stood up till late in the third period. Leafs finally won it 2-1. Leafs leading here 1-0, first period at the 9-minute mark. Brad Smith has the goal. And the Blues shoot it up to center. Mahar had it poked away by Iafredi. Bourgeois, number 4, nearly gave it to Cortnell. That lateral pass, Benning, though, is in. Dropped it back. Another pass going astray inside the Leaf line. And Cortnell decides to clear the zone. Reeves turns. Flipped it in. Here's Ronning. He fell. Regan out of the net to dump it away, but it went right to Ronning, who took the shot, hoping Regan wasn't back in. But he was there. Iafredi starts around the goal. and he was hit hard by Ragland. Thomas coming in now, shot, ripped a hard one wide. Meyer Grady shaken up on a heavy hit from Ragland. He has gone to the Leaf bench. Federko starts out. Napras to Ragland. Federko missed it. Five turns. Got away from Bothwell. Five in centered it. And a check, failed to reach it. Here's Wendell Clark in there against Federko. Puck is cleared out by St. Louis. Napras coming up with it. Napras just rolled it in over the line. Lemieux in against Lance. They're up and up a bit. Comes back in the slot. The Blues. Bothwell tied up, kicked it loose, in a check, flipped it toward the line, a breakaway for Clark and five, and he's alone, five, stopped by Millen, five again, at the line, and he has to come out. Millen makes the big save on Rick Five. Clark was with him, now in a check, missed the net on the short side, five, knocked it in behind the goal, in a check, given a bump by Ramage. Puck is loose there in the corner. Federko kicks it free. Now he rolls a pass up on the left side and Cavallini streaking away. Rolled it into the right of Regan. 11 minutes gone in the opening period. 1-0 Toronto. Five. Stopped on a breakaway. Allison trying to go in. And he's stopped from moving in on Benning. They push at each other. Domfus rolled it in along the boards. And the Blues clear it out to center ice. Cavallini going in. He's got a good shot. And Regan kicked it out. Cavallini could really fire him, and he did that time, but Regan had the angle covered beautifully.
Yeah, well, he didn't have to move to stop, but it was a bullet, and Regan looks confident. He had that angle cut right down.
Regan out of the net, chopping at it as Gilmore was coming in there. The Leafs lead 1-0. Nearing the 12-minute mark, and Ramage has to be careful going back in there. Comes right down to Rugged. Some heavy work going on in behind the play. Daou broke the stick, and he goes down to the Leaf bench. Smith on the ice again, and here's Iafredi coming in. Sends the pass back out over the line. And the Leafs are offside on that play with Salming trailing. And, of course, we'll be watching the scoreboards from out of town tonight. And there's an important game, Hartford and Quebec. And boy, they're having a whale of a series, they're telling us. Quebec on the verge of pulling an upset. Not going to be easy, though, against the Hartford Whalers. Potter coming up the center, flip one in. That's Regan, firing it to the corner. Therrien, a pass to the line, intercepted. Therrien gets it again. Rolled it out to Yaremchuk. Therrien and Smith go in. Here comes Smith. Crowd going again as Smith goes in there forechecking. He's knocked down. Smith nearly intercepted that pass. It got out to Hunter, though. Then up on the left side, Federko going in. Federko looks for it against Salming, and Lance comes back to help for Therrien. Therrien turns along the boards and starts out for Toronto. Up the center, flip one in. And the Leafs will make changes quickly. Nearing the 13-minute mark of period number one. 1-0 Toronto. Bourgeois fires one in. Mahar trapped it. It goes for Reeds. Back of the net. He's taken out of the play. At the line, Ronning shoots one. It's deflected right to Reeds. Reeds back to the line. Bourgeois the other side. Benning's shot is blocked by Rick Five. Now Gill goes back to the net as Regan stopped it for him. Cleared it on the boards down to the St. Louis line. 6.5 minutes left in the period. Here's Ronning going in. Oh, what a glove save by Regan. He has done that so many times in this series, and Ronning thought he had a goal there. What's that we were saying, Harry, about playoff goaltending? You saw it again right there.
They stop. Ronning lets a good shot go, and they put Ronning into play a little bit for Wickenheiser because the checking line for St. Louis has not scored a goal, while the checking line for Toronto has scored three this series.
Ramage, a high shot on the glass, right to Daou, all the way back there. Allison, another checker, got it out to center. Toxopoulos ripped it in. There's Allison. He has the puck on the boards. held there by Bruce Bell. Domfus comes over to help. Knocked it loose. Cavallini is there for St. Louis. And Gilmore will go around the net. Gilmore, fake to pass. Now he has to leave it for Ramage. Bell deflected the puck up to the Maple Leaf blue line. 5:35 left of the period. 1-0 Toronto. On the goal by Brad Smith. Ramage stepping in there. Shot off the goal. And now can't clear it. Pavlovsky has it. Centered it. Cavallini fanned on it. Lead pass for Allison. Off his stick and in. And the Leafs will change again. A little over 5 minutes to play in the period. Blues trying to get one. Up to center Natras. Stopped by Clark. Lemieux carries on. Here's Lemieux again. Backhands it in front of Leggett. Nobody was there. But there's going to be a penalty called on the play. Dan Daou behind the play, I think, Harry, was called for slashing.
It was on a St. Louis line change, and he got caught almost getting run into the St. Louis bench. And as he left, he turned around and slashed the St. Louis player, and Koharski watched it. And the faceoff's at center ice, because when Millen came out of the net on the delayed penalty call, the St. Louis skater jumped over the boards before Millen got within 10 feet of the goal. And when that happens, the linesman blows the whistle, and they penalize St. Louis the distance.
And we're down to 5:02 left of the period. Daou in the penalty box. So now, a big test for the Maple Leafs. St. Louis Blues, good power play. Fourth in the regular season of 21 teams. The Leafs have held them in check on their power play in these playoff games. Leafs shoot it in, Carrion and Allison. Up front, Salming and Iafredi in the defenseman. The Blues, Ramage and Federko. Two key players along with Hunter shooting it in. There's Federko. He's bumped by Iafredi, just a light bump, but he took him out of the play. And the Leafs are going to clear it out. Salming will bring it to center, drag it a bit. Now he decides to backhand it in. Allison goes to the bench, so does Iafredi. Cardinals on the ice with Bill Root. And Tyrion up front. In for the Blues. Betting shot from the side of the net. Root chopped at it. Federko stopped it. Federko played it up along the boards. Blues power play. Now they'll whip it around. It comes in front of Gilmore. And he was covered in time by Salming. And it's cleared by Courtney. 50 seconds left in Daou's penalty. That is Ramage. Ramage coming out. Gilmore will carry across center and play it ahead. It's off the stick. Bill Root got his stick in front of it, and the puck flies into the crowd.
Well, Toronto in the last two games that they've won have done a great job on the St. Louis power play. 5 for 27, but they haven't scored in the last two games. And St. Louis is a team that relies on playing you even at full strength and taking advantage of that good power play, and that little piece of strategy is not working for them now.
Chris Kotsopoulos is out there again for the Maple Leafs, playing in a second game since January. He'll be Ron McLean's guest in our first intermission. And Don Cherry will be along again on his coach's corner. 3:41 remaining in the period. 1-0. Brad Smith, the goal scorer for the Maple Leafs. Leafs lead the series and wind it up tonight with a win. That's Ronning coming in there. Ronning, robbed earlier. Nice glove save by Reagan. Now the Leafs, Allison over there trying to pick it up. Allison lifts the stick, gets it ahead to Therrien, and he gets it across the line. 15 seconds left in the Daou penalty. They haven't been able to get near Reagan so far. Here's Ronning taken out of the play. Therrien is back in the net. Got away from Cavallini's check. Root knocked his man down. Cavallini ran into Root. The penalty is over. Daou's on the ice. Bell's shot kicked out by Reagan. And the Leafs get it out across the line. Therrien trying to roll it ahead to Allison. Now shoots it up across the St. Louis line. Blues clear it again. 2:45 remaining in period number one. Here's Kotsopoulos up to center and Clark with five. Clark's shot. Blistering shot, but just off the net. Flipped over the boards at the St. Louis bench. Play call. 2 minutes and 35 seconds left in the first period. Toronto Maple Leafs lead 1-0. Doesn't sound like much, but in this kind of a series, Harry, seems to be a lot.
One goal has stood up for a long time in a lot of games.
Rothwell checked by fell to the ice. Ramage for the Blues. To Bothwell again. Here's Bothwell stepping to the line to center into Reeves, and Lahar's offside. Close call. But he was offside at the Maple Leaf blue line.
Well, a strange turn of events. Neither goaltender wants the water bottle that they allow them to put on the top of the net. And usually at least one, especially at this time of the year where the rinks are often hot, you'd think they'd have it. But I guess they wait till there's a delayed penalty and go to the bench. Hartford's not dead yet. Dineen makes it 3-1 Hartford. And Quebec has not got the right to play the Montreal Canadiens yet.
Brad Smith's first goal of the playoffs at 2:55 in this first period. Giving Toronto a 1-0 lead. And here's Clark, who assisted on that goal. Coming back in there, stick handling through, and then he was put off stride before he could get the shot away. The Blues, Reeves to center ice. Reeves with Wickenheiser on his right. Five stripped him of the puck. Five took a swing at it, and it gets out across the line. Blues dump it back in. Five going to the Leaf bench. They make changes, so do the Blues. 1:30 left in the period. This is Daoud shooting one in for Toronto. Milling out of the net. Shots are 7-4, St. Louis. And the Blues coming up to make that 8 now. They can. Hunter is in there! Great save by Ragnar Hunter! He was flying in there. Cardinal is stopped by Bourgeois. Rolled it into the St. Louis zone, though. Cardinal is nailed by Bourgeois at center ice after the play. Into the final minute, Konerko lost it as he crossed the line. Osborne can't play it. Now it's cleared in. Bothwell, 45 seconds left in the period to Bourgeois. Bourgeois stopped, now he scooped it ahead. That's a glove pass to Hunter.
Well, Reggett makes a great stop on Hunter. Hunter hasn't scored a goal in the playoffs, but he has a great chance here. He cuts right in, getting away from Osborne. But watch Reggett get that leg over. And Hunter should have hung on to it, tried to go all the way across the net, but Reggett wouldn't let him.
Actually, a good play by Hunter, but Reggett had one a little better. Leafs in there with another shot for Millen to handle off Iafredi. Therrien left it there for Allison. 30 seconds left. Therrien again. Back to the net, and that was scooped into the line. Salming stopped it. Therrien went after it. With Allison getting it back to Salming. His shot blocked by Millen. Therrien was in there close, looking for a rebound.
Well, Millen, who's played three games in St. Louis, but none here in Toronto in the playoff, got the starting assignment tonight. And in each of the losses that he suffered in St. Louis, a long Leaf shot ended up being a major factor in the Leaf win.
18 seconds left of the period. Faceoff deep in the St. Louis zone with Daoud there. He got the faceoff. Salming's pass went in behind Therrien. And the Blues, Nat was looking up at the clock, just gave it to Cavallini, ahead to Pasloski. 8 seconds left, the Blues are in there. To the corner with 5 seconds left. Big center, and Reagan covering up just as the horn goes to end the period, and the Blues coming very, very close to tying it there.
Well, there's Dan Daoud and Gilmore fencing. And of course, Gilmore hasn't appreciated the close attention Daoud's giving him. And I wouldn't be surprised before this game gets much older that one of the St. Louis heavies takes a run at the Pest here, 24, and tries to get him involved in a major or a misconduct penalty. Because Daoud's a feisty player, and he doesn't care how big or how many, he'll take them all on.
Breakaway by Brad Smith in the first period, the only scoring play. Reggett sharp again tonight for Toronto. Federko against Yaremchuk on this opening faceoff. Yaremchuk happy to be getting a chance to play. Rolled it up over the line. Now Hunter just dumps it in, and the Blues will make changes right away, of course. Out for Toronto, that's Vibe. Gave it to Yaremchuk. He couldn't handle that pass. It was bouncing a little bit on him. Puck slapped in by Salming, wide of the Leaf net. Salming behind the goal. Salming playing about 8 to 10 minutes a period in this series. Up to Yaremchuk, his lead pass. Failed to get anywhere. Here's Ronning coming in. Ronning shot, that was blocked by Iafredi. On the boards, Vibe looking for it. Now he sees it, gets it out across the line. Benning shoots it back in for the Blues. Salming with Ronning watching him. Iafredi, a pass to Vibe off the boards. Up to center, that is Vibe. Coming to the far side, now he rolls a pass over for Clark. Clark breaking from the head around the goal. Wendell Clark looking around for somebody open, got it back near the line, and Rick Lance had a notion to move back out, then moved up a step to clear it in. The Blues stayed out with it. Benning again. Pass hitting Ronning. Ronning going in with Hunter shooting. His shot was deflected away from the net by Salming again. Up the center, it's tipped in by Clark. Now he's going to the Leaf bench. Osborne on the ice, going after Lemieux. Bumped him lightly. Lemieux couldn't get by Thomas. Leafs keep it in. Here's Lemieux again. Left it there in front of the net for Natras to Lemieux. Across center ice, the Blues coming in. Lemieux trying to go through the Leaf defense, but stop. Long shot by Bothwell, missing the goal. And Natras takes it. Natras to Bothwell again. Up across center, and he'll dump it in. Todd Gill going back. Gill to the corner, slides a pass ahead. The Leafs clear it out. That's Courtnell speeding away. Courtnell coming in, shoots. Low shot, missing the St. Louis net. Gill stopped it at center. Now Osborne back to the other defenseman, Bill Root. Root fired one in for Toronto, and Millen, the goaltender, out to stop it. And Bothwell in there. Bumped again by Osborne. Osborne going in forechecking. Doesn't make any difference if the puck has passed out. He'll get a piece of the net.
That's a good policy because the defenseman that's making the play often will make it a little quicker if he knows that guy's going to finish his check. When you make things happen a little quicker, your chances of making a mistake have increased.
Bruce Bell looking pretty good on this rush to Gilmore. Gilmore getting right in. And he backhands the puck to Reggett, who had him guessed perfectly. He didn't move and just made the save off Gilmore. This is Bob Cole with Harry Neal, Ron McLean, and Don Cherry at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. And this is game 6 of the best of 7. The Leafs up a game, 3-2, and up a goal in this one, 1-0. Nearing the 3-minute mark of the second period. Brad Smith moved back a little bit. Gilmore wins the draw. Pazlowski's shot. Blocked by Salming. Can't clear it though. Leafs, three of them in front of the net. They skate away with it. Now up to Smith. Smith shoots it in the boards, in the corner. And it rolls to Pazlowski. Smith went in and bumped him. Therrien tried to center it. Therrien again. Looking around. Therrien handling the puck away from Pazlowski. Pazlowski pins him now. And Gilmore grabs it and sweeps away in front of Millen. Up to the line at center. This is Gilmore coming in. No room. Iafredi skated right into him. Salming given a bump behind the net by Cavallini. Bell to Gilmore. Gilmore is stopped near center. Ramage turns. Pass to Cavallini on escape. Iafredi through the middle it goes. Now coming in with Smith. Now to Smith. Got in front. And the pass actually was behind him a little bit. He couldn't bring it back in with the backhand. Bell for St. Louis to Cavallini. Cavallini, bumped by Smith. Gilmore rolled it in. Great chance for Reeves. And he lost it. Reeves in front of Reggett. And you know what happened there? Reeves was waiting for Reggett to make a move, which he did not do.
You're right. I think Reggett, standing his ground, made Reeves change his mind. And when Reeves made his mind up to go to his second so-called move, he lost the puck. A nice pass here puts him in. Leaf defensive must have thought the winger had him. Now watch this, Reggett's there. But actually, it looks like Reeves just got a little too fancy. He was gonna shoot, then he was gonna stick handle, then he ended up doing nothing.
Reckitt, the stand-up goaltender again, just stood there waiting for the St. Louis player to make his move. Then when he wanted to, he found he didn't have the puck anymore.
And Todd Gill looked like the villain on that pass over to Reeds, but really it wasn't. The winger had Reeds, and right at the, as he hit the blue line, he let him go. And Gill, who thought the winger was covered, was standing up, looked over, the winger's not covered, and that's a lonely feeling when that happens to a defenseman.
Inacek winning the draw, back to Lands. Lands again. Pass to center to Inacek, and he is stopped immediately. Once more, Lands poked it ahead. Here comes Byam on the right side. Quick Byam gets the shot, deflected by Botwell's stick. Inacek scooped it into the corner. Inacek got loose. Links after it, forechucking well. Gill shot for the line, kicked away by Millen. And it goes over the glass into the crowd. Millen watching that one all the way. Live on CBC, Hockey Night in Canada. Federko for St. Louis. Got the draw away for Lemieux. And Hunter is coming out with Lemieux carrying in. Dropped it to Hunter. Hunter can't shoot from that angle. Centered it though, right in there. Oh, a great chance for Bourgeois, and he missed the net. Three Leafs come right back in with one man back. This is Thomas, centered it. Osborne was in too far. Thomas again, trying to give it to Osborne. It went through his skates and Lemieux was there. Again, Thomas. Cordell went after it. Here's Osborne, quick shot just off the net. Get rid of it to center. Thomas having nightmares in this series. In alone again and elected to pass. Benning coming in. Offside, Lemieux on the left wing.
Well, two great chances. One for Bourgeois. And then Thomas tried a late pass across on a 2-on-1. And these two guys, again, came up big. Here's the St. Louis chance. Bourgeois, who's in the slot, pulls it across and tries to backhand it. I don't know whether his stick was taken. Now here's Thomas. If Thomas wasn't in a slump, he'd have shot the puck here. But he passes it, and Millen, who's so far out of the net, probably helped Thomas make that decision to pass, but it had to go through too many people, and it was too close to the net.
Still 1-0 Toronto. The Brad Smith goal in period one. I am Brady now. Drilled his shot and Millen got a piece of it. Allison moving up. Now Foose back to the net. Knocked away by Bell. Bruce Bell's pass on the boards and the Blues get out. Here's Gilmore. One man back. It is I am Brady. Gilmore coming in on him. And I am Brady played him all the way. And the Leafs take over it again and come out. Pass through center. Now Foose in there. Now Foose waiting for help as the Leafs were making changes. And the Blues stealing the puck, get it up across center. Gilmore, knocked flying by Dan Daoud. Leafs Dom Foose got away from Gilmore. Dom Foose, very cool with the puck, a lot of patience. Ramage going after Daoud and Rick Lands, and now Gil gets into it.
Well, you knew that was going to happen. The St. Louis players are not going to let the 165-pound Gilmore fight any battles. And it was just a question of time before someone took a run at the guy that took a run at Gilmore. In this case, it was Daoud. Well, Daoud, who has been a real pain to Gilmore, has just hit Daoud earlier. And here's Ramage's reaction to it. And here's what caused Ramage to lose his cool. And really, there's nothing wrong with that. Ramage didn't like it. You saw what he did, and it's going to cost him a penalty.
Ramage got two minor penalties, and Lands of the Leafs got a minor penalty.
Now, St. Louis threw two water bottles out to the goaltender, Millen. And the referees won't like that, and they'll warn the St. Louis bench once. If you want water, put it on the back of the net. Don't have your players throwing those things out on the ice, or I'm going to give them a penalty. This is after Ramage hit Daoud. He takes a run at the nearest white shirt, and it happened to be Rick Lance. And St. Louis Ramage is their premier defenseman. They can't have him running around solving other people's physical problems. They need him on the ice.
He's not on the ice now. He's in the penalty box. And he'll be there serving the minor penalty, and the Leafs will go on the power play again. Land's got 2 minutes for the Maple Leafs. Ramage, a pair of minor penalties for St. Louis. 1-0, Toronto leading on the Brad Smith goal. Islanders up first against Washington tonight. St. Louis stopped by Ian Brady. 5 in the corner. Left it for Inachak. He couldn't center it. 5 again. Fake the pass back to the line. St. Louis with a 4-man box, keeping the Leafs on the outside. They have not a shot yet. Here's Kotsopoulos. That's onside. Salming. And here's 5. Ripped it hard. And Kotsopoulos can't stop it on the side.
Well, again, the St. Louis Blues are pressuring the point, men.
Maya Brady coming in. Stops. Got it back to the line. Kotsopoulos having to hurry. Rolled it ahead. Into the corner. Tart got it back to him. Kotsopoulos. Tart waits. Now Tart on an angle. He might shoot it from there, though. Steps in. Lets it go. And that hard shot grabbed by Millen. And the St. Louis goaltender hangs on to it.
Well, Clark did the right thing probably by shooting it, but he should have shot it as soon as he got it. He waited till everybody got set, and you can see what St. Louis's philosophy is in killing the penalties. Let's take the Leaf point shots away and make them try and make an inside play with their three forwards. And Toronto hasn't been able to do it too often, and as a result, nobody gets a good chance.
1:09 left in the penalty to Ramage. Weckenheiser on there against 5 on this faceoff to the left of Millen. 5 tied him up. And Clark looks back to Kotsopoulos, to Clark again. Clark's pass to the side of the net. Inachak around the goal, got it back. Inachak once more from Salming. Salming got rid of it. 5 has to hustle. Poked it over to Clark in the corner, and he lost it. And the Blues, Weckenheiser sends it down to Reagan. 45 seconds left of the penalty. Leafs lead 1-0. A lead pass gets down to Clark. Clark coming in there. Clark nearly got through. Hit Bourgeois, but Bourgeois had time to clear the puck for the Blues. Reagan out of the net. To Kotsopoulos, to Courtnell to center. Pretty good move by Courtnell. He dropped it to 5. And his shot missing on the short side. Again, Benning is there to shoot it out and down the ice. 15 seconds left of the penalty. 5 had a great chance seconds ago. Courtnell turning, coming out against Reeves, shoots it in. Millen out of the goal. Millen left it there. Thomas went in. Now Ian Brady on the boards with it. The penalty is over. The Blues have killed another one. Here's Courtnell being stopped by Mahar. The Leafs still on it though. It's Thomas coming out, took a shot. Couldn't get a second shot though, with Reeves getting it away from in front of the net. Now Courtnell had it taken away by Mahar. The Blues shoot it down the ice off Osborne's stick. 8.5 minutes gone. Second period, 1-0 Toronto. Bill Root leads the attack by shooting it in. There goes Thomas after it. Bourgeois left it for Bernie Federko. Federko coming out, he's covered. Evans missed it. And Ian Brady has to hurry back. Federko nearly got in there. Yaremchuk watched Osborne play it. Yaremchuk again. Now he left it for Ian Brady. Back it goes. Out to Ian Brady. Back it goes again. And Salming now starts it out. Salming to center. Flipped the long one in wide of the net. Bothwell after it. Blues back into that checking, but they can't check all night. Now the Leafs have it. A centering pass to Smith. Tried to go around Millen. Nearly had another one. Hunter is in there now. Hunter shoots it down the ice for St. Louis.
Two dekes in one night might be a little much for Motor City Smitty.
The penalty against the Maple Leafs was to Therrien. There he is in the penalty box. 2 minutes slashing.
Well, again, Bob, we're halfway through a game and there's only been one goal scored. This has to be the lowest scoring series that's gone 6 games that I can recall in the last 5 or 6 years. used to happen quite often in the 50s, but not in the 80s.
Running got the draw. Cut to the line, and here's Brooks Bowen shooting. Back stopped by Reggett. Off the boards to Bell again. Stepped away from Allison. Gives it off to Cavallini. Back to Bell. Bell can't shoot it by Allison. He had him checked. And now Bell misses it. And it's into the center ice zone. Allison stole it from him. Allison upended. Penalty coming up against Bell of St. Louis. Credit the checking of Allison on that game. Penalty call.
Bruce Bell committing a young defenseman's mistake in the National League. He made a mistake. He couldn't keep the puck in. Then he gets deked and has to trip Allison. And it's quite often a young player makes a mistake, gets upset, and follows one mistake with another one. And that's a classic example right there by Bell.
And a minute, 25 seconds left in Therrien's penalty. Here's Rick Five turning at his own blue line, coming in on Bourgeois. He got by him. Now he's upended. Still after the puck as he goes into the boards. And Bourgeois covered him. Little pushing and shoving. Bourgeois gets his arms up on Dom Foose of the Maple Leafs. Now they're all in there.
Well, there's a little skirmish breakout after Five tried to beat the St. Louis defenseman Bourgeois, and they slid into the end of the rink. Now the question is here, it's a trip if Bourgeois doesn't touch the puck before he trips Five. You be the judge. That's a trip if you let the referee see it from the angle we saw it from.
9:35 left of the second period. Still 1-0, Maple Leafs. Federko up the center. Therrien will be on in 1 minute. Hunter comes in and put the shot to Reggett. He cleared it to the line, not out. I afraid he has a chance to move it up ice. Gives it to Courtnell with Osborne coming up with a Courtnell shot. Stopped by Millen. Ramage after it. Back out for St. Louis. Hitting Hunter and then Benning. Back to Federko. To Ramage, he missed it. Osborne up with Courtnell. The pass intended for Courtnell was intercepted. Now Iafredi going in there. Iafredi, he had Osborne in front of the net, couldn't get it over to him. Courtnell moving up on Federko. Federko stopped Courtnell, and Benning is in. Ramage takes over for St. Louis. 15 seconds left on the Leaf penalty. Therrien standing up, anxious to get back on. Ramage got away from Minichak. Ramage to shoot it in now, and the Blues will make changes. And Therrien is ready to step on the ice. Five kept it back, and here's Therrien on the ice with Inichak coming in. Inichak with Five looking around for him. Inichak to Lance. That shot deflected and didn't miss by much. And it went over the glass. Five coming close. Inichak coming close, but it's still just 1-0. This program is copyrighted and is strictly for the private use of our audience. Any reproduction, retransmission, distribution, or exhibition in whole or in part without the express written consent of the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation is strictly prohibited.
The Washington Capitals are having trouble putting the Islanders away, and there may be a seventh game in Washington Saturday night.
8:14 remaining in the second period here. 1-0 Toronto. Brief power play for the Leafs. 10 seconds left in the Bell penalty, and the Blues get it out across the line. So that will do it. Bruce Bell is now back on the ice. That penalty over. Reeves, number 15 for St. Louis. Tried to hit Bell, missed him. That's Lands turning at his own blue line. Allowed to come to center now. Roll it into Clark, going in. Clark right in there. And Five missed the puck in front with a net empty. Lands shoots. That's stopped by Millen. Leafs come close again. Penalty coming up, St. Louis. Bothwell grabbing Rick Five and hauling him to the ice. He didn't like it. Five didn't like it either, but the Blues get a penalty.
St. Louis defenseman Tim Bothwell takes a very foolish penalty here. Five wasn't going to get the puck, and Bothwell tackled him and then had the audacity to argue about it. Here's the play with Clark coming in. He makes a nice play to get around the defenseman, but then he can't quite pull it back far enough to beat the sprawling Milne.
St. Louis Blues, shorthanded, shooting it down the ice. 1-0, Toronto leading. Second period, with a little over 7 minutes remaining. Smith poked it ahead, but Wickenheiser gave it to Gilmore. Gilmore is bumped lightly at the blue line, and the Leafs get out to center. Domfus and Thomas. Here's Domfus, hanging on to it. He'll wait. Now rolled it in back of the net, and Smith was hit by Benning, and he went into the St. Louis goal and knocked it askew all the way back to the boards.
Well, Smith's very upset. Benning interfered with him, or hooked him, or tripped him. Smitty was going for the goal. See him on the right here. Now the pucks are, Damfus got the puck away over at the other boards, and you can see why he's mad. Benning just hoists him into the goal. And this is the second time in three games Smith's hit the same crossbar at the same end. He doesn't like it much, but he's not going to go off. I think he can smell another goal.
It was Smith who scored in the first period at 2:55 for the Maple Leafs. Clark drew an assist on the goal. It was really a breakaway by Smith, set up by Clark. He deked Millen, and that's been the story. 1-0 for Toronto.
Well, I have to marvel at the Toronto Defense Corps playing as consistently well as they've played in 5.5 games, making only a few major errors. And we know all year they had some terrible breakdowns, but not in the playoffs.
The Blues moving it up to center. This is Benning. Benning carries across the line with Mahar and then telegraphed that shot. And it was easily deflected over the glass behind to Ken Reggett.
Benning's a great young prospect. He was supposed to start play this season for the Canadian Olympic program with Dave King, where he played last year. But because of the injury to Ramage, he stayed at the start of the year, and he's had a wonderful season. And he's a guy you have to watch when St. Louis is behind. He rushes the puck well. He joins the rush well. He's got a real good shot. He looks tired to me. He plays a lot of hockey.
That game at Madison Square Garden in New York, Philadelphia. Would like to wrap it up. Toronto Maple Leafs leading 1-0, and the Maple Leafs would like to wrap up this series. They have 6:40 to play in the period. And it's Reeves stealing the puck for St. Louis. They're shorthanded. Minute left in the penalty to Bothwell. And the Leafs will have to come back to start this power play from behind their own net. Osborne got the pass. Mahar on him right away. Hatsopoulos starting Osborne again. The Blues doing a fine job forechecking. Now Allison, he was standing still taking the pass. It's difficult to move it. Now Allison brings it in himself. Allison to Cardinal. Cardinal lines up. Good move. Put the shot. It's deflected. Hatsopoulos flipped it to the corner. Back to Hatsopoulos. The drive. Knocked down. Allison was robbed by Millen. Allison was on top of the rebound very quickly and got a backhander away, but Millen made a big save.
Well, Kostropoulos' shot was missing the net, that hit Ramage and bounced right down to Allison, who backhanded it, but Millen beat him.
20 seconds left in the St. Louis penalty. Bothwell in the penalty box. Watch this again.
Watch Kostropoulos, he gets the shot away. It hits Ramage. See Ramage in the left part of your screen there? It hits the St. Louis penalty killer stick off Ramage's chest, right to Allison. And he missed it, or he looked like he only got a bit of the puck, and it hit Millen in the skate.
Now they're ready. With five into the faceoff spot, he decides to skate out, or Kevin Collins decides that he'd better skate out. And Daoud comes in. Daoud's tied up, and Gilmore grabbed it. Gilmore flipped it on the boards down the ice. 10 seconds left in Bothwell's penalty. The Leafs start up again. Five takes it down the right side, cuts to the middle to Clark. Clark coming in, good move. Clark, another good move. Finally, lost it. Bourgeois out. Bothwell is out of the penalty box. And the Leafs clear it outside the line. Hart takes it again. A wide pass. Nearly backfired with Gilmore in there. Just missed it. Clark rolled it up in the corner. Clark spills it. Back of the goal. He's tied up. Clark after it. Back to Lance. A shot by Lance. Oh, and it just rolled by the open side. Rick Vive is nailed in front of the net again. And Gilmore nearly got a breakaway. He missed it. Near center ice. Break it out of the net to dump it over to Daou. Four Leafs up on this rush. And Gil is in. Center net. Nice save by Millen. Again, Therrien couldn't hit Vive. Vive without the helmet now. He's down again. Boy, is he getting roughed up in this second period. Vive stopped it. Got it back. Roots pass. Hit Yaremchuk. Yaremchuk turning in a corner to Vive. And Millen made a big stop on Rick Vive, who tried to tip it in. Back for the Blues. Failing by a goal. Reagan kicked it out. Another shot. Reagan kicked it out. Another shot. Off his skate, Reagan made two biggies right there, and the Leafs hang on. Therrien is onside as this crowd gives Reagan a standing ovation. There he is, and there they are.
Well, this enthusiastic crowd is acknowledging two great stops by Reagan. Watch Vive get a pass across here from Yaremchuk, and he just redirects the puck, and Millen, it hits him in the skate. Now here are a couple of Reagan saves here. Here's the rebound right out to Evans. He shoots it. It's on the money. Reagan makes the save with his left foot, and he makes another one here on a turnaround shot. Pretty tough to win when you can't beat the goaltender.
Some kind of hockey here in the playoffs.
Watch this.
Reagan has been a standout.
Ah, they don't make him any better than that. And he was ready for this one, but it never hit him.
Wow. 4:14 left of the second period in a 1-0 hockey game, and a goaltender stymies the Blues again.
I don't know about that one, but he'll get some votes tonight for that.
Faceoff just out to the left of Reagan. Federko against Daou. Getting down to the late minutes now in the second period. Daou tying up. Federko comes back to the line. Bourgeois. And Reagan there again. Stick save this time. He has been positioning himself perfectly for these St. Louis Blues. And when they do catch him a little bit out of position, he's got the great reflexes in his game.
Well, he's made two big saves off this young man, Bourgeois, who's not known as an offensive defenseman. Look at his face. By the end of the playoffs, two-thirds of your team will have black eyes or cuts. And Bourgeois, who's taken more hits from one player, Wendell Clark, in any series I've seen, has been on the wrong end of a lot of number 17's good, tough play.
4:09 left of the period. Again, a face-off in the Leafs zone to the left of Reagan. Federko again against Daou. Daou won it this time. Cleanly. Back of the goal, that is Salming. Hatsopoulos takes his pass. And he wanted to go back to Salming, then had to hurry his pass. It got out. The Blues are coming on a bit now. A little stronger in the late going of the second period. And it's Salming dancing away with it. Got it ahead. Daou through the middle. In with a long shot. High off the net. It bounced by Millen. And he had to turn around a couple of times to find it. Lemieux gives it to Federko. Back to Lemieux to Federko. Federko on the boards. Taken out of the play by Salming. Here is Manning getting set. The screen shot didn't get through. And the Leafs. Daou could clear it. The Blues keep the heat on Toronto. Salming had a stick grab by Federko, and Daou helped him clear down the ice. 3:20 left of the period. The two teams make changes again. As Lemieux had his pass stopped near center by Cortnell. Here's Brad Smith again. Shooting! And he just missed to the far side. The Leafs hustling, keep it in. Back of the goal is Benning. Benning fired it ahead. Blues skating through is Federko. Look out! A pass back in front and it's cleared all the way down to the St. Louis line. Bockwell, rink-wide pass, open ice there for Salming to Cortnell. Cortnell coming in. Cortnell turning. He's having difficulty over there against Pasloski. Pasloski got a pass to Federko with Cavallini coming in. Cavallini grabbed by Vive. And he hammered him in on the boards behind the net. Pucked up the center. Cortnell went over there, but the Blues still come at the Maple Leafs. Lands bumped by Cavallini. In for St. Louis again. Dropped back, and Cortnell was there. Up with Brad Smith. Cortnell at the line, coming in to Smith again. He shoots it off to the corner, and Ronning is there. That's blocked behind the net by Cortnell. Smith missed Ronning with a check. There's Smith again with Allison. Allison is taken in on the boards, and the Blues recover with 2 minutes left in the period. They're throwing everything at the Maple Leafs now, trying to tie this hockey game. 1-0 Toronto. Gill, being watched by Ronning, to Lance. Cavallini went in and hit him. Cavallini fell on the play. Allison to Cortnell, shoots. Hit down by Miller, and he backhands it just wide of his own net, let me tell you. Exactly what he was doing. Some of the fans oohed and aahed. Bothwell flipped one in. Reggett watching it. A minute and a half left in the period. Allison had the puck go off him down the ice. Benning turns, trying to charge in for St. Louis. High stick making contact, so when Katsopoulos picks it up, you get the feeling, Harry, the Blues are coming on a little stronger now.
Certainly in the last 7 or 8 minutes, they've mounted a much more dangerous attack than we saw for the first 33 minutes.
Benning shot, Reagan saw that, cut his arm up to stop it. Gilmore bumped on the boards, Reagan stopping it again, flipping it back of the net for Salming to Osborne. Osborne ducked it ahead. Now just rolled it in. We're into the final minute of the second period. And still only one goal in a hockey game. The Maple Leafs have it. Benning to center, rolled it in. Reagan will come out of the net again to knock it away. Gilmore fanned on it. Gilmore has it a second time, though. Centered it. Mahar's in there, and he's nailed by two Leafs before he could get a shot. Dao swings to the far side. Gilmore hit him hard. Here's Mahar in. And the play is called. Dao checking on Gilmore for five games now. I'll make this five games and two-thirds just about. At that time, Gilmore saw his chance.
He sure did. He saw Dao not looking, and he gives him a real royal treatment right here. Watch it. Could have been elbowing, could have been tripping. Wasn't anything. And I like players like Gilmore, who's been batted around. He's only 165 or 70 pounds, saying, I'm going to solve my own physical problems. And if Dao's going to bother me all night when he isn't looking, he's going to get a face full of blue uniform.
31 seconds left of the period. Toronto 1, St. Louis nothing here in Game 6. The Leafs want to wind up the series tonight. The Blues want to see a seventh game back in Missouri. Up to center ice. It's backhanded in. Five tried to deflect it and missed it. Evans back of the goal, lost to Tart. Tart couldn't center it. Bothwell stopped it. Five went in there. Here's Katsopoulos from the blue line. And he has difficulty with it. It rolled out. He tried to knock it back in. Here's Hunter coming in just as the horn goes to end a hectic second period. And the only scoring play back in the first, Smith from Clark at 2:55, and it's still 1-0 Toronto.
I'm sure John Brophy instructed his players that they have to go at St. Louis. They can't sit back and allow St. Louis to come racing at them offensively. Look for St. Louis to rush their defensemen. Their defenseman joining as the fourth man in the rush, pinching along the boards and the Leaf wingers who aren't great on the boards, moving off the point into the slot in the offensive zone. All those things that you'll try when you're behind in a life and death situation that you're afraid to try under normal circumstances.
The Leafs shoot it in first. off the stick of Wendell Clark. In a check, in forechecking. Benning, the young defenseman, clearing it out. Stop near center, and the play is called. It hit us in Lewis player, I believe, at the bench. And the play is stopped. You know St. Louis will have to take it to the Leafs. That's right, Harry. And you also know that Koharski will be watching this third period as closely as he did periods one and two. The Leafs on the power play tonight are 0 for 3, and St. Louis 0 for 4.
Now, Don Koharski's got a nice feel for the game. He knows the importance of this game, and he doesn't want to be the guy that decides. And I don't think you'll see much in the way of monkey business, because both teams know how much damage a silly penalty could cause.
If a seventh game is necessary, of course, it'll go back to St. Louis Saturday night. Right now, 1-0 Toronto, and the Leafs could end this series tonight. Benning lugging the puck well again, but he made the move at the line, and Hunter was offside. Little bumping in front of Reggett. That's Thomas and Hunter, and now they're jawing at each other.
Well, Hunter hasn't scored a goal in the playoffs, and he was a 36-goal man during the season, although in all fairness to Hunter, he's had a bad shoulder, and probably if it was the regular season, he wouldn't be playing now. But there's no time for the wounded to rest during the playoffs, and a lot of guys play, and they might normally not.
Leafs solving to Thomas. Thomas stick handled away from Federko and gets up a bit of speed. Now he's knocked down as he tried to cross the blue line. Natras caught him with a check. Hoffwell in front of the net. Portnoy forechecking. Thomas checking his man. Natras over along the boards. Blues can't find anybody to start the play. Leafs just keep picking it off and sending it back in. Thomas's pass is stopped. Federko skates across center. And the Blues are going to do anything, and he'll have to get going. Federko 24. In on the boards, he goes. Thomas has the puck. And he clears it out. Again, up comes Gill. Todd Gill tied up by Federko, but carried on as he got loose, tried to flip a high one in, and did. Got it high on the glass. Top of the wall. Really? Haslowski to center. Minute and a half gone in the third. 1-0 Toronto in game six. Domfus brings it in there, and Allison couldn't control the pass to goal with Cavallini on top of him. Gilmore coming out. Dalou is going to be on him. You can mark that one down. Take that to the bank in this third period. Cavallini up to center. Domfus stopping Pazlowski. The Leafs are checking tenaciously now on the checking St. Louis Blues. 1-0 Toronto. Long pass goes astray. Icing is waved off. Bill Root back there. Cavallini in after him. The puck over the glass. Into the crowd. 2 minutes and 15 seconds have been played in the third period. Toronto leading 1-0 on the Brad Smith goal way back in the first. From the faceoff, Daou winning the draw. Salming around the net. It goes out to Allison. He chops at it and gets it out of his own zone. Bourgeois turns with Raglan coming in. Raglan set it up. Ronning going in. Oh, another great save by Reggett. On Raglan going for the far side, and Reggett got a piece of it. Here comes five. Here's Inachak. That shot deflected wide of the goal. The Blues stymied again by the goaltending of Ken Reggett. Nearing the 3 minute mark of the third. Blues come at him again. Ronning to center, did not control it. Bourgeois steps up there, rolled it into Ronning. Ronning, the little guy, going along the boards against Salming. It's centered, and the Leafs pick it off and get it out. It's Clark. Five is trailing. Clark's quick shot, stopped by Millen. Nearing the 4 minute mark. Out for the Blues again. Lead pass to Reeds, and he's stopped by Lands. And Vive backs up, can't get it out of the zone. Reeds is bumped by Lands. Vive trying to get off. He's been on there a long time and obviously is tired. In on the boards is Vive trying to hold his man Hunter. Hunter got loose, and so did Federko, but now Portnoy went in there. Four players fight for it in on the boards. Cardinals can't stop Federko, but the Leafs are going to get it out of the zone. Up the center, Cardinal trying to go in with Thomas, and Bothwell turns. Stopped by Gill near center, backhands right back in there at the 4-minute mark of the third period, and still 1-0, the Leafs forechecking. Thomas centered it. Cardinal couldn't play it. Here's Bill Root. Shoots! Scores! This place goes crazy. The Leafs are up 2-0.
Another one of those long shots that have plagued Greg Millen. I don't think he saw that, or if he saw it, it was deflected. The puck comes right out to Root, right here, after taking three bad hops from a St. Louis viewpoint. There's the shot, and I think the lead player cruising in front, Steve Thomas, got a stick on that. Yes, he sure did, and you can see it deflected off Millen's stick into the corner of the net.
And they're still standing and cheering.
Time 4:07.
The time of the goal is 4:07, and we'll check on the official for you. They announced Dan Daoud, but I'm sure that will be changed. An unassisted goal. There's Daoud, backhands the puck in. The Leafs are up 2-0 now. Rink wide pass did not work. Cavallini tried to go into Gilmore. Out it comes to Nakris. His long shot off the boards to the right of Rugged and Allison on the ice with Don Fusidou. They're going to check the Blues now. They can. Benning is checked by Dan Daou. And there's Allison, the other checker, trying to make a move around Nakris. Out for Benning. Boy, he's been carrying the puck a lot tonight for the Blues. Again, the Leafs check them at the blue line. Domfus coming to center. Allison is with him. Domfus rags it. They want to go off. Millen steers it away for Cavallini. 2-0 Toronto, nearing the 6-minute mark of the third period. It's fired in and Lands grabs it. Clark has it. Rink wide pass stopped near center by Bothwell. Ramage at his home line. Ahead it goes. The Leafs are all back here now. They give the Blues very little room to maneuver. Leafs clearing it again. And got by Raglan to center. And the play is called with a Leaf net. Knocked off the Magnets again. Little rough stuff going around there.
Watch Reggett make a save here on young Ronning with his right foot. Ronning knows how to score goals, I can tell you that. He scored in every league he's been in, and you can see how upset he is that he didn't stop that one. They've given the Leaf goal to Root. I guess it did not hit Thomas's stick and hit Millen's stick and deflected under his arm into the net.
They're just singing the goodbye song here at Maple Leaf Gardens, but you know, they've got that one queued up a bit early. Listen.
Singing it, you can be sure of that. It's a little early for him to even be humming it.
Coming into the sixth game, but the Maple Leafs needed a pair of goals. I'm sure they'd be looking to other places than Brad Smith and Bill Root. Here's Cardinal now, one of the guys you would think would spark the Leafs offensively. It's centered, back of the net again. Smith got a goal in the first period. Now Root here in the third. And Ronning is coming up there. Ronning dropped it back and it's out over the line. Cardinal steals it. Gets going. He circles away from two checkers. Cardinal going in. He shot, rebound. He scores.
About three great plays there, and look at that.
somehow squeezing it by Millen, who went down, giving the Leafs a 3-0 lead. They're all standing up and going nuts.
Watch where Cortland's speed is when he scores. They're behind the icing line. The only thing in front is the stick. He had about 1 inch to shoot it. And Tim Boswell, after the initial shot, turned to the left instead of staying with Cortland and allowed him to grab the rebound.
6-12. In a deafening Maple Leaf Gardens, the Leafs go up 3-0. Another unassisted goal, this one by Cortnell. Now Vibe kicks one loose. Bourgeois for St. Louis. To Hunter, and he's nailed hard by Vibe. Koderko moving in, dropped it on the line. Reggett kicked out, and another chance by Koderko, and he fanned on it. Leafs are going to clear. Clark got it to the center ice area. Here's Inichuk fighting hard against Reeds, and he got loose. Bottom off and rolled it in. Hunter coming out. Inichuk was nailed by Bourgeois behind the play as Hunter goes in. Koderko gets sent. He had it knocked away. Here's Vibe coming out. He has Inichuk, and Clark is catching up. Vibe ripped it right up the goaltender Millen. Tried to blast it through him. Cavallini's pass, grabbed by Pazlaski. Pazlaski falls. And it's the Leafs back there checking again. Now, nearly got a break at center. He's up after it. Knocked it in behind the net. Nearing the 8-minute mark of a third. 3-0, Maple Leafs. And they can wrap up the series with a win tonight. Pazlaski. And his pass stopped. Can you believe this checking turned in by this Maple Leaf team tonight? Again.
Excellent hockey without the puck, Toronto. And they haven't been known for that all year.
Cavallini flipped it in. And here's Gilmore stealing it. No room to move. Nailed by Rick Lenz. Domfus to center. Domfus coming in. He rolls it off to the corner. I think it's about time that somebody started looking over to Gary LeRivière, the assistant coach, and the head coach, John Brophy, and saying, fellas, you've done something else with this team in the last month.
No question about that. Players don't play with this discipline because on the way to the rink, they've not thought of doing it. Somebody's been pounding it away, and it's getting through, and the Leafs look excellent.
They sure do. Thomas nailing Ragland, who's a tough customer. Gets up with his head shaking. Ronick shoots it in for St. Louis. Nearing the 9-minute mark of the third, and there's Osborne, another excellent checker. Giving it to Cortnell, giving it to Thomas. Thomas at the line to Cortnell again. He centered it. Osborne tied up by Mahar. Love pass, won't work. Play call for a faceoff in the blue zone to the left of Greg Millen.
Here's how Behaima thinks of it. It's his first, well, he scored one earlier, but that's his first picture goal of the playoffs, and he's got a few of them in this rink this winter.
Koderko was nailed, trying to lug the puck across the Maple Leaf line. Clark got away from Koderko. Backhands it in. Takes a hit as he does. During the halfway mark of the third period, Toronto 3, St. Louis no score. Kotsopoulos ran into Hunter, stepped up from the blue line to hit him. Bill Root grabbed the puck as Inichuk took the man. Down it goes. Bourgeois left it for Bothwell. Up the center, that's Cavallini. Flipped the high one in. Reagan has been a standout in this series. Pazlaski centered one. The Leafs clear it. And if he can hang on and continue to play the kind of hockey he has been playing in goal for the Maple Leafs, well, this series is over. Leafs are up 3-0. Gilmore, again, he's hustled. So much so he had to hurry his pass. That was knocked it down. But there's a Leaf there. Allison is there now. Here's the Tom Foose up the center, and two Blues charge at him. Cavallini bumped by Allison. Gill takes the puck. Lots of time in there. Back to Gill. The Blues are making changes. And the Leafs throw it back and forth. Now it's Gill playing it out to Dom Foose. To center. Mahar drops it to Ramage. He hits Mahar on the fly. Mahar's in! And he misses the net. He fired it wide. That will happen when you have a hot goaltender. You're trying to put him in off the post. And many times you throw it wide.
Reggett's play does get in the head of the St. Louis shooters.
8:50 remaining in the third period. Toronto leading the series 3-2. Up 3-0. They're in again. Osborne can't play. Put the shot at Millen. Shook him a little bit, but he knocked it away. Again on this side, Thomas. And the play is whistled dead offside.
Mark Osborne gets a roughing penalty with 8:33 left. It's not quite what John Brophy wanted, and it took place after the whistle. I'm not sure John saw that, and a lot of people in the rink didn't see it because many of the players were heading toward the bench for a line change.
So Osborne, with 8:33 left in the period and in regulation time, is off for the Maple Leafs. Is hooked from behind and can't move. The Blues now on a power play. They're 0 for 4 tonight. This is their chance now to score. But I am afraid he comes out to center, striding in there for the Maple Leafs. Shoots it to the corner and it backs up and goes to the Leaf bench. Federko, Ramage, Hutter, Gilmore, Benning. These are the five Blues starting out. Federko to center. Federko brings it up to the line. Has to backhand it into the corner. Bill Root is there. Root around the net, lost it. Got it back with a diving save. And Therrien shoots it down the ice.
Well, there's a lot of players for the Leafs given that little extra, and that's probably the difference between St. Louis and Toronto, two very evenly matched teams.
Center ice, Benning. At the line. Backhands it in. Gilmore looks in front. Federko is there. And the Leafs tear it out. Speedster, they're not going to catch him. And Millen stopped it. He got a piece of it. Again, Courtnell fanned on it. Once again, it's Allison. Back it goes to Katsopoulos. I don't think these fans are going to sit down anymore tonight. They're up again.
Well, Brian Benning hit Courtnell with a wicked slash just as he was about to make the play, and he may have diverted Russell's attention from scoring his second goal of the night.
7 minutes left in regulation time. And it's St. Louis on a power play in there again. It's Cavallini going to the corner and getting it back to the point. Here's Bell, shoots one, and he misses the goal. On this side, Natras flipped it in along the boards to Pasloski. Back to Natras, another screenshot, tipped up a rocket, and he grabs it. And the whistle goes with 6 seconds left in Osborne's penalty. 6:39 remaining in regulation time, and 6 seconds left on the St. Louis power play, and Lemieux takes it, centered it, Salming is down, and Reggett got the loose puck in the crease again with 1 second left in Osborne's penalty.
Well, you know there's not one Detroit Red Wing player not watching this game in Detroit. They now know who they're going to play, or they're fairly sure. They've had 9 days off. They practiced today for the first time since eliminating Chicago 4 straight, which is a little too long, and I'm sure Jacques Demers would agree with me there, but it's good for their veterans like Harold Snepps, who was dynamite against Chicago in the first round, Dave Lewis and Higgins, both who have got slight injuries.
You can rest assured that Jacques Demers will have his Detroit Red Wings ready for the next round.
Wasn't it Jacques that said it would take a miracle for the Toronto Maple Leafs to make the playoffs?
The miracle is very close at hand at the moment. Not only making the playoffs, but going on to the round against the Detroit Red Wings. And they keep playing this checking style that we've seen here in the third. And to boot, they've got a goal. And then another. 3-0 is the score. Toronto leading with 6 minutes and 10 seconds left in regulation time. Allison makes short, gets out and down the ice. And again, the Leafs make quick changes. Now 6 minutes left in regulation time. And the Blues running out of time. Dropped back to four Leafs by Federko. Inachak in there. He dropped it. Back to Inachak from five. And he couldn't play it. Now Bod shoots and he hit the goal post. Nailed it off the post. Rick five, a bullet shot. Clark back to Lance. A drive, that's wide. And again, Inachak. Inachak in front. Inachak can't shoot it. And the Blues get it out, but there's Inachak again. Waiting for the Leafs to clear the zone. Takes a hit on the boards, it goes in on Bourgeois. There's Clark trying to knock it loose. Inachak gets it back. Clark gets in there. Can't get a backhander by Benning. Inachak without the helmet. Chasing Bourgeois. Everybody is putting out now for the Maple Leafs. And the Blues know it. They have little room to move. They're down 3-0 and less than 5 minutes to play in regulation time. The Blues go in again. Gilmore into the corner. He knows they have to get something going. They have to get one soon, or it'll be all over for sure. Gilmore knocked down behind the net. Leafs covering up to the line. It's stopped by Ramage. He has to hurry it in. And it's Domfus coming out with Osborne. Domfus going in there. Osborne waited for the pass. And Domfus could not relay it back to him. Cavallini to Hunter. To Cavallini again. Long shot. Deflected off his stick. Hits Salming's stick. And Domfus takes it out. Soft pass. Maybe a little too soft for Dahou. And the Blues are called. And a penalty is coming up now. Dahou and Gilmore going at it again. Dan Dahou drawing the frustration of Doug Gilmore again here in this hockey game. And at this late stage in the third period, Gilmore of St. Louis gets 2 minutes for cross-checking. It's 15:49, so 4:11 remaining in regulation time, and the Leafs are just that far away from moving on against Detroit.
To give you an idea how well Toronto's playing in front of Reggett, and obviously Reggett, is that they've given up 2 goals in the last 3 games, except for the 4:11 left here. And you can see that Gilmore's had just about enough of Dahou and gives him a little swat.
Faceoff outside the line. In it goes. Benning played it off the boards and down the ice, and Salming back there. Here comes Mahar, but he won't stop Salming. He's skating perfectly now, hitting the line. Going to center and gliding in. Faked one way, went the other, still has it. A good rush by Salming. Takes a look around. Salming well in control. Very cool, at the line, threw it in along the boards, and finally it's off Allison's stick, and the Blues get it out. Evans played it up to Mahar. His shot deflected wide of the Leaf net. 3.5 minutes remaining in regulation time. Allison's pass, hitting Lands, the defenseman moving up. Two Leafs went in there, and Corbo missed it. He had Thomas with him. 3:25 left to play. In regulation time, 3-0 is the score, Toronto. Wickenheiser can't reach it. It's Cordinal taking the pass near center. It's deflected away. Ramage, rink wide pass. Up the center, that's Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser tried to clear it in. Knocked down up the line by Thomas. Takes a shot and misses the goal. Millen did get a piece of it. Behind the net in the corner is Thomas. Thomas cleared it on the boards and got it out to the line. There's Rick Five. Shoots it across the line. Back to Thomas. Thomas waiting. Back to the line again. There's a drive by Alfred. And Millen just got a piece of it. 21 seconds left of the penalty to Gilmore. Up the center. Wickenheiser drives one in. That's wide. 2:20 left to play. And the Leafs watching Evans around the net. Two of them will come out. Osborne to Clark. Clark in. Backhander. Millen stopped it. Clark centered it. Score! It's 4-0. Inachak scoring. Blues of St. Louis.
Do you think the Leaf fans can start the song now, Bob?
Cue.
And the fans have been chanting, "We want Smith." And this guy, Inichuk, he's played a whale of a hockey game tonight.
Yes, he
has. When he gets in the right mood, he's a premier player in this league. Clark nearly scores here on the shot. Then he gets the rebound right here, and he can't put it over him. And he just touches the puck through the mop to Inichuk to put it off the post and in to cinch Toronto's victory over St. Louis.
Clark and Osborne, and that's a power play goal at 17:51. And yes, now they can sing.
I think the players wanted to give their coach Brophy a little present, a power play goal. And there's Smitty, who got the Leafs going with an early goal in this game.
2 minutes remaining in regulation time. The Toronto Maple Leafs defeating the St. Louis Blues in this series in 6 games, leading now 4-0. And they're still chanting for Smith. Here's Federko going to the Hunter, stopped by Reggett. Reggett doesn't want to let one in at all tonight. Just might happen, which will mean that it does happen. The goal by Smith will stand up as the winner. However, a minute and a half left. Let's see what happens. Bourgeois back. Up to Benning. Benning coming in. Gets in the slot. And now the Leafs are going to work hard for that shutout for Ken Reagan. Puck cleared back in. Toronto. Nearly 18,000 are on their feet as the Toronto Maple Leafs scored a goal in the first and made it stand up for 2 periods and about a 3 here in the third, and are on the verge of eliminating the St. Louis Blues from further Stanley Cup play. 1 minute left in regulation time. Brad Smith in the first, Ruth Cordell and Peter Inichuk here in the third. The Leafs 4 and St. Louis nothing, and the tempers a little short now, but this one is just about over. I'm Bob Cole, and with me is Harry Neal in the broadcast booth at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. And what a heck of a series this has been, this Norris Division semifinal.
Break his hand and be gone for the next round, and they're going to need everybody they have to beat the Red Wings.
Ramage and Kotsopoulos are going to go, and there's going to be another bit of a scrap down here. A man who has starred for St. Louis is number 9 in the blue. That's Gilmore. And a man who has checked and throughout this series very effectively in the white, 24, is Dan Dowd. And Gilmore has been completely frustrated.
Absolutely. And give Kevin Collins, the linesman, some big marks. He stopped 2 guys from getting into it, Dow and Gilmore, when the other linesman was escorting Ramage off the ice. And there's no need for Dow and Gilmore to be fighting. It's a tribute to both of them. Dow, the way he played, and Gilmore, the attention John Brophy thought he had to give him to beat St. Louis.
Dow will go to the Leaf dressing room as we're down to just 51 seconds left. And Gilmore goes to the St. Louis room, and they're finished for this series. Only 51 seconds remaining, and this man here, Ken Reagan, a standout in every game in the 6 games that we've broadcast. Tonight, he's had just 19 shots. Now, that does not sound like much, but let me tell you, folks, they have been quality shots from St. Louis tonight. Reagan,
well, eight
has
or nine
been
of them,
outstanding.
8 or 9 of them have been superlative stops. And Bob, when the game's 1-0, for as long as it was 1-0, a big save is much tougher to make and much more important.
just to say, nice going, Reggett. And Reggett is saying to Smitty, nice going, Smitty. It's just a curtain bow, yeah.
Stoppus wants to see the end of this game.
For St. Louis, Rob Brennan,
he hasn't had a chance to play since January the 21st. There's Gary Lehman on talking to him. He broke his kneecap, and you can bet how agonizing it is for him not to play. Now there's Brophy saying, let's get this game over with. And Harold Ballard is happy for the team. He's happy for Maple Leaf Gardens Incorporated. And who knows how far the Leafs can go. Great hockey, especially since the new year. And don't forget the deceiving record that Toronto has against Detroit. Most of Toronto's wins came before the new year.
A goal in the first and three in the third. The story of this one, along with the solid goaltending of Ken Reagan. 30 seconds left in regulation time. St. Louis offside. And a faceoff coming outside the Maple Leaf blue line. Seconds to play. Reagan had one shutout last year in the playoffs against St. Louis. 3-0. It's 4-0 now. He hasn't done it yet, but he's just about done it. In a check, who has scored a goal here in the third with Allison. He dumped it back to the net. The countdown will start any moment. They're down to 12 seconds. Up to center and one more shot. And it off the glove of Reagan and wide. And Reagan has his shutout. And the Leafs have advanced, winning the series. 4-2 with a 4-0 win tonight. Jacques Martin and the rest of the coaching staff of the St. Louis Blues, John Brophy and Gary Lariviere. It's been a tough series, well played series, but it's over now. There's a guy who wish he could have helped, Brian Sutter.
He was at the rink at 3:30. He was going through the same ritual he would have gone through when he played. He'll be back next year and the National Hockey League will be better for it.
So the Leafs have defeated the St. Louis Blues 4-0 tonight. He got the first goal, turned out to be the winner. Didn't look like it then, that was way back before they hit the 3-minute mark of the opening period.
Watch Wendell Clark and Charlie Bergeron. They've been at each other the whole night. I guarantee they got great respect for each other.
For certain, the Blues have, there they are, that's Clark. Coming up is Bourgeois.
This tells you what the game's all about, right here. There it is, right there. Two guys are trying to kill each other for a week and a half.
Well, this one is over. Reagan with a victory sign. And there's another standby Leaf who didn't rest for this series, Bob McGill. But they're all in it now, one way or another. And they beat Detroit in the next round, beginning next Tuesday at Joe Louis Arena.